Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MTK Global. I'm here in the changing room of Dave Allen. He's just out the ring after a spectacular knockout of Lucas Brown. As his coach, advisor, whatever you are, how are you feeling?
Yeah, over the moon. I'm buzzing for him, you know. He's worked so hard. He really has. And he deserves it, you know. You get what you put in, you know, get out what you put in, and he's put in loads of work. And yeah, you know, I'm looking at it from a coach's perspective. He was a little bit, wasn't moving as any much I wanted him to, but look, what we worked on was slipping to the outside, throwing the right hand, or slipping inside, throwing the left of the body. And you know, he nailed it, perfect. I'm happy, I'm over the moon.
So that's a shot you've been working on this?
There was the slips and throwing the right hand and the left of the body.
Worked perfectly then, didn't it?
Yeah, it was.
So, as his coach, are you hoping to be in the corner this time? I mean, you're suited and booted, as you can see. But are we going to see you in his next fight with the training top on and in the ring, giving the constructions?
Probably. Mick as well, you know, he's helped and got him into the position where he is, so he'll always be part of the team. And I'm just over the moon. You know, there's the point of having to do my licence, etc. But I tell you what, I'm knackered. I'm sweating. I ain't stopped running around today. I've been up and down. I've been working on the box, doing the world feed. I have not stopped. I am sweating. I reckon I'm down to about light middle now, or super welter.
So what are you saying? Is that a comeback then?
No chance. Well, after watching that, no.
Definitely not. Well, again, he's over there talking with Coogan just now, and he mentioned David Price and the likes of Derek Chisora for his next fight. I mean, you do have some input in what's next for David, I suppose.
That's from the advisor point of view.
Yeah, so what would you like for David next?
I quite like, I've heard Derek Chisora talk about Joseph Parker. So in that case, I like David Price fight. It's a very hard fight. I respect David, as does the White Rhino. He's got that amateur pedigree. He's a great fight. He's been in some big fights himself. But it's a fight, I think, it's probably the right one for Dave. You know, stylistically, I think it suits him.
So when would he be out there? It was just announced that Dillian Whyte is facing...
The 20th of July. I'd like him on there because I don't want him to go into his he has his moments there where he switches off a little bit, but I want him to stay on it. He can have a week off, he can eat all he wants and eat a bit of crap, but I want him to keep his weight down. That was a good weight for him. I'd like to maybe even get down to lower 17s for him, so he can be a bit sharper with his head movement and his hands. But yeah, 20th of July is perfect.
So again, the heavyweight division is up and down at the moment with certain things we spoke about at the press conference and whatnot. I spoke with Eddie at the weigh-in, he said he's possibly three fights away. He might not be a world champion, but he's three fights away from possibly facing a world champion. Do you echo that, what Eddie said?
Yeah, look,
or two
I mean,
fights now, I suppose.
Well, look, he's a former world champion. Whatever you think of Lucas Brown, I know he suffered that big knockout defeat to Dillian Whyte, but he's still a worthy champion or ex-champion. And I think now he's only, you know, a big win against David Price, not overlooking him if that is the fight that's made. But you're not far off, are you? You know, don't get me wrong, the big guy is maybe a little bit unrealistic, but still, he's in line, I think, for something big.
Derek Chisora just walked in with a thing. One last question. How serious? If Eddie can't find an opponent for Joshua, you, as an advisor, would you chuck Alan's name in there?
Yeah, of course. Get him straight in there. What's he got me?
Well done, mate.
So that's a yes. What's that? Okay, there you go. Like, Derek Chisora brings
five again. Guys.
So that's a yes then from you.
Will I sing him in with AJ?
Yeah,
why not? Look, it's the heavyweight division. Anything can happen. It would be amazing, wouldn't it? You know, for him to fight MSG against the heavyweight champion of the world. This is nothing to lose, is there? But he's not gonna get it, I think. I've got a feeling Ortiz would get it, but anyway.
Before I let you join in with the celebrations, I've got a touch on it. Miller got caught three times. What's your thoughts?
Ban him for life. Ban him for life.
That simple.
Are you he's admitted it. He fell to that, mate. I'll ban him for life, 100%. He's admitted sticking needles into himself to cheat. Ban him. As simple as that.
Well done. Congratulations.
Cheers,
once again.
Mate. It's been a pleasure seeing you this week.
No, mate. Again, it's been a pleasure seeing you. My pleasure as well. But I'll let you get back and celebrate because you know you had a moment, you know, a chance to see you.
Oh, you're a burger now.
Halfers.
many.